that one, as it's more balanced. Unfortunately, I am going to have to raise the military budget again. To enable us to crush this uprising, and then we may actually go to war with some of our neighbors from Yemen. Just because we can. And to kill some time. Spanish Bonin Islands. It is now a protectorate. Good. Good. And I apologize for not talking much, but at this point, there is barely anything going on for me to discuss. Screw you, Italy. You took territory I wanted to colonize in Northern Africa. I'm not giving you a damn thing. As I was saying, there's not a ton going on right now. We're just basically killing time. Which is why a lot of what I'm discussing is just random ramblings. Okay. We will click on that. No, Egypt, I'm not giving you military access. I don't care about you. Austria-Hungary, there's another crisis. Now we're sending the army to destroy these guys. And let me see. I think, let's see. Hejaz here are allied with Nejd and Oman. So I'm going to justify a war over them to establish a protectorate. And just because I'm bored, I'm going to try to conquer this whole region. Which means, just because I'm a little paranoid and stuff, the redeployment of our military, of our combat fleet, over to the Middle East. And unfortunately, as much as I would like to, we're not going to be attacking the Ottomans or Persia. And thanks to my stupidity, we can't take Abu Dhabi, because the French got it. Since calling them in made them war leader. We're just lucky they gave us Yemen, since we occupied the capital first, I think was why. There we go. Rebellion put down. Netherlands fighting some random nobody. 90, so another 3 months to justify our war. Well, 3 months and a bit. And the crisis is still going on. Tech to research. Let's see. Blah-de-blah-de-blah. Admin efficiency. We were detected, but I don't really care because we have plenty of room in our infamy to justify a couple more wars. And actually, I am going to reduce my military spending for the time being. We'll raise it again once we get closer to declaring the actual war. I just want to save money while I can, seeing as we're probably going to go into bankruptcy as I try to conquer this region. We have gained established protectorate, and I'm going to be raising the military spending right now. So let's see what happens. And we won't be calling in France this time. Now we'll wait and see what happens. First of all, we'll send in Cuba's massive fucking army. To occupy the entire place. Let's see now. And they're the only ones we're at war with currently, I think. Let's see. Balance. And we'll split our army up a bit. And occupy the entire country. And then annex them. Go. Now you need to be balanced. And I don't know. Is this little island? No, it's part of one of the mainland territories, so we don't have to occupy it. Something got built. Probably a factory, if I remember the sounds this game does rightly. And while we're doing that, Nejid. Oh, they are allied with Egypt. That might be a problem. What about Oman? They're allied with Hejaz, and apparently at war with us. I didn't even notice that. Yep, you heard it here first, folks. Didn't notice I was at war with Oman. So I guess I'll wait, and as soon as we finish these occupations here, I am, in fact, going to occupy Oman, and we will conquer them too. It will probably be an economic disaster for Spain. But I just don't care. There's not a whole lot to do right now, so I'm just gonna go to war with whatever minor imbeciles there are available. And those of you who are veterans of this game are probably screaming at me that I'm being an absolute idiot. And you're right, I am. But keep in mind that this is the first time I have ever played this game before. Pretty much. Before I started doing this Let's Play, I'd put maybe 2 hours into this game. And to anyone who's done a Paradox Grand Strategy game before, then you know that that is absolutely nothing in comparison to what you need to do. Oh, and we're already at war with Nejid. Hang on, let me check. Who did I end up at war with? Oh, those guys. Maybe I can conquer all three if I do this right. Might involve some more waiting and being at war than you might think is a good idea, but I'm fine with that. Farming efficiency. More admin efficiency, and we'll keep on going down that track. I bet it's pointless by now, though. There is no way I'm gonna save Spain's economy. Hang on a second. Sorry about that, everyone, but I just had to mute my microphone because I started this with no water and I had to cough for a second. Let's see here. I think we'll start occupying Nejd next. Repay debts against the United States of Central America. We don't care about them. Well, so I'm not going to be going to war with these folks. Let's see here. What do we do now? Let's see. We'll send the army of 8,000 to occupy their capital. To, persuade them to surrender to me. We'll select those 5,000. Let's see, this 8,000 strong army here, I'm going to split up. We'll send 5,000 down there. Yeah, we're just basically dividing the army so I can occupy... so I can occupy them as fast as possible. Sorry about that. It's a little loud in-game. I'll be lowering the volume in my editing program, but still, it's kind of loud in the actual game, so give me just a moment. Really should have thought of that, but Paradox games do tend to be pretty goddamn loud when you first start them up. And that's a little quiet for the sound effects. Much better. And this is what we're gonna do. Of course, this won't be the conquest. This will not be the conquest of all the territory of my opponents, or will it? I thought that Oman had some land somewhere in the actual continent of Africa, and they did. Let's see. I guess they lost it to one of the other European powers. Not surprising. It was a single province, after all. But what I am surprised about is that if that happened, Oman stuck around for long enough that I can conquer them now. a volcano killed a lot of people in the Dutch East Indies. The Boxer Rebellion was successful in the Chinese Empire. Which, I don't actually know a whole lot about the Boxer Rebellion. East Asian history, with the exception of stuff like the Mongols, isn't exactly something I know much about. Canada's been released as a satellite, as has Colombia. I think that happened a long while ago, and I just didn't notice it. And, of course, my idiot move of releasing the Philippines because of one rebellion, leading to me barely not being able to defend my holdings in the Pacific from rebels. Pain in the ass indeed. And we're still waiting for our occupation of enemy territory to finish up. Which is not taking a colossally long amount of time, and oil, is that going to make our economy better? I don't know the resources in this game, I have to admit. That place has been occupied, so we can send our army to help out in Omaha. Liberal and anarcho-liberal victory, which I'm sure the king is absolutely distraught over because we just had to crush a rebellion by those guys. Yemen loses militancy. Excellent. Now, you can go occupy them. And I'll check what this crisis is once I actually get troops into this Omani province. No to whatever your peace offer is. Okay, let's see. Crisis. Return of Greece's rightful territories. France is backing them. As well as Austria-Hungary, and the British are backing the Ottomans, and so is Germany. This could be interesting. It'll probably be another France v. Britain war. I'm just gonna ignore those pop-ups now, I think. Again, oil. France accepted status quo. So, things didn't essentially go to hell. You folks can meet up there. Morocco's less militant, always nice. We're moving to 1886. And now we need to move this army up there. Hmm. or not. We're about to finish up with one of those occupations. Finish that research. More admin efficiency. And we'll send a few extra soldiers in to help out, just in case it makes things faster. More conservative, yes, yes. Now, let's see. There are no reforms we can enact, which is a colossal pain in the ass. I'm ignoring your peace offers on purpose, by the way. Just in case you people are wondering, I am deliberately ignoring the peace offers I get from them. Once I fully occupy all my enemies, then I will dictate peace on my terms. Revolution in Romania. Don't care. And we have people building factories in our country, which I do not give a damn about. There, we won our last occupation. It is now time for us to dictate terms of peace. Oman. Add war goal. Establish protectorate. We will gain 10 infamy. Let's see. What about Nejd? No, that would put us over our limit. If we added a war goal there, we would have 26.5 infamy, and anyone in the world could declare war on us. We don't want that. Let's see, 12th of July. There, you want a white piece? I say no. Actually, Nejd, can we ask for anything from them? 10 to make puppet. I'm going to have them dismantle all their fortifications. We're going to make Nejd weaker. Actually, no, we're not. Oman. Post peace. Peace offer value 170, and we have a war score of 100. So I have to choose. I didn't notice that. Damn it. I'm going to try anyways. They're fully occupied. They rejected our peace offer. Not surprised. But hedge a debt. For this, I'm going to check what resources they have in the territories. Where is that map mode? RTO, let's see. Wool, grain. Yeah, wool and grain is what they have. Opium, fish, fruit and grain is what Oman has. Oh, it's really, do I want opium or wool? And last time I checked, wool was the more valuable resource, but they only have the one. Wait a second. There's an unoccupied province in Hejaz. I'm going to occupy that before I make peace. Fuck off. Honestly, I wish there was a button in this game that you could tick and automatically reject all peace offers until you reach 100% war score. Let's see here. We apparently have a war score of 100, but I'm still going to occupy this last province, just in case it gives us the option to take both countries. I don't think it will, but I want to try. The United States and Hawaii have gone to war. Wow. And it is now 1887. They still would not accept. Let's see. How do I figure this out? Let's see. Our top exports are fabric, iron, fruit. Wool can make fabric, so it might make more sense to take the province, take Hejaz, because they have the wool, and wool makes cloth, which is our top export. I think I'm gonna go with that. Everyone who's watching this will probably right now be telling me how I am an imbecile for having done so. But that's what I'm going to be doing. When did we stop being allied with Belgium? Again, I accept. The United States annexed them. And our glorious peace offer has been signed, and Hejaz has surrendered. Actually, now I'm going to do this. We'll have 15,000 troops here in our new colony of Hejaz, and 21,000 on the border with Oman. By the way, Oman, when can we go to war with them? How long does our truce last? Oh, until 1893. So when that time rolls around, we will be going to war with Oman, and I imagine our infamy will be low enough by then. And France wants an alliance too, alright. I'm still miffed that you took northern Morocco before I could, France, but I suppose we can be allied for now. So, let's move these troops into here, and now